Hey everyone, I'm Natalie with Autel Robotics. Let's get you started on some basic flight maneuvers with your X-Star Series drone. Let's prepare the X-Star for flight. Keep in mind that though it's super fun and we've made it pretty intuitive to fly your X-Star drone, practice makes perfect. So make sure you understand the basics of how to fly before you take on any complex maneuvers. If this is your first flight with your X-Star drone, beginner mode will be enabled by default in the Starlink app. This mode will limit your altitude and distance and slow down the overall speed of the X-Star. This is a great tool for when you're first learning to fly. You can disable beginner mode in the app under the flight control settings menu. When you're first learning to fly, we recommend choosing a nice, wide open space. Start by choosing a safe location to take off. You'll want to position yourself behind the X-Star drone with the battery facing you. For a new pilot, this will help make sure you stay oriented while your X-Star is flying. The left command stick will control the ascent, descent, and yaw or rotation of the X-Star. The right command stick will move the aircraft forward, backward, left, and right relative to where the camera is facing on the aircraft. Go ahead and launch the X-Star and let it hover at a safe altitude. If you're unfamiliar with how to take off the X-Star, check out our video on taking off and landing your X-Star drone. Now, let's try to fly in a square pattern. Using only the right command stick, push forward and the aircraft will move forward. And pulling it right will move the aircraft right. If you pull back, the X-Star will fly backwards. Pushing left will pull the aircraft left. Keep the aircraft in front of you when you're first learning to pilot. Now that you've tried out these basic maneuvers, it's time to get a little disoriented. Be cautious when you're first attempting these maneuvers. With the X-Star hovering and the rear of the aircraft facing you, as indicated by the slow flashing green LED lights, use the left command stick to gently rotate the X-Star 180 degrees so that the camera is now facing you. You can tell that the aircraft is facing you by looking at the solid red LEDs on the aircraft. Now use the right command stick and slowly pull down. You'll notice that the X-Star is moving away from you, and pushing forward on the right command stick will fly the X-Star towards you. If you push the command stick left, your aircraft will now move to your right, and vice versa. Pushing it right will move the aircraft to your left. By doing this exercise, you can now see how the controls are a little different once you've rotated the aircraft. That's why it's easy to become a little disoriented when you've rotated the aircraft. Learning how to master these controls could help prevent you from making a wrong input on the control stick and thus also prevent a crash. You can practice managing these controls by rotating your X-Star 90 degrees with that left command stick and then playing around with the right command stick to get a feel for how the aircraft reacts. Now try to fly in a circle pattern using both the left and right command sticks. Flying a circle can be a pretty complex maneuver for new pilots. Once you've got the circle down, another exercise you can do is flying the X-Star in a figure eight pattern. It's always good practice when you're coming in for landing to rotate the aircraft so that the rear of the aircraft, indicated by those slow green flashing lights or the battery, is facing you. This will allow for easy controls if additional inputs are needed during the landing sequence. And now you're practically a pro. But don't forget, practice makes perfect. To learn more about flight operations, check out your user manual. Thanks for watching.